Hello, I'm Stephanie with Vaudio, and welcome to part two in our video series about how to create custom static graphics for the AV Bridge Matrix Mix.
Vaudio is a US-based pro AV manufacturer whose goal is to make your AV experience easy. Our AV Bridge Matrix Mix is a full production video switcher that includes HDMI, USB, and IP streaming outputs, and its easy interface lets first-time users run a high-quality presentation with minimal experience.
Our previous video discussed the basics of video layers and keying. In this video, we'll be discussing how to plan and design graphics so that they add value to your video. There are a few things to keep in mind when you're creating a graphic. What part of the screen will the graphic occupy, and will that obscure anything important that the video cameras are capturing? How big should it be? Is there text that's meant to be read? Does your company or community have any color schemes you should use? And how long will an audience be looking at the graphic? The point of a graphic is to communicate something with the audience, so we want to make sure that our message is clear. Let's start with considerations for text, because a lot of graphics may contain textual elements, then you want to make sure that your audience has an easy time understanding them. There are a couple of things that can trip you up with text over video, and you may have encountered one of them before when watching a subtitled movie. Cue example.
Que la force soit avec toi. À jamais.
Wow, what's French me saying? Let's try that again with an outline around our subtitles.
Que la force soit avec toi. À jamais.
Much better. Because video shots and colors can be unpredictable at times, especially during a live broadcast, adding an outline or a background in a contrasting color ensures clarity. It's also a really good tip for anything else on your video that you want to make pop. Since we're talking about contrast, this is a good time to bring up another consideration for text, which is color choice. When you're selecting colors for your text, you're going to want to balance the needs of two different groups that might be in your audience, folks who are dyslexic and folks who are colorblind. Very high contrast in text like pure black or pure white can be harder for dyslexic audience members to process. Lowering extreme contrast can make it easier for them to understand your content quickly. And reducing extreme contrast is also much more pleasing to the eye for a lot of viewers. On the opposite end, contrast is key when designing legible graphics for colorblind folk. Some color combinations may look like they have enough contrast to folks who experience the full range of color, but if you desaturate them or convert to grayscale, you can see that they're confusing to look at. A good guide is to pick a pale or pastelish color and match that with a darker shade. So you'll want to use colors that provide a suitable amount of contrast without being the most stark amount of contrast that's available to you. If you're looking for a go-to basic color combination, a dark gray paired with a cream or off-white works great. Another important decision is the size of your text. Consider how your audience will be viewing the video. Are they going to be sitting in front of a computer screen? If so, then you can pick a font size that is comfortable to read in the image editor that you're creating it on, though you may want to go a size larger if you expect that your video might be compressed, like over a video conference. If your audience is going to be seated farther away from the screen, a good guideline is to have text be a minimum of 1 inch for every 15 feet away from the screen, measuring from the farthest viewer. In metric, that would be 25 millimeters for every 4.5 meters. Lastly, let's talk about font choices. Serif fonts, or the ones with those little hook or eye details, make reading printed words much easier as the details supposedly carry your eyes from letter to letter. However, on screens, sans serif fonts are much more legible. Now, this might become less true over time as screen technology becomes crisper and clearer and people upgrade older monitors, displays, and projectors. But for now, it's a good guideline to design for older or new mid-range installed displays that you will find in a majority of spaces. Sans serif fonts also offer a clean look, which is really in design-wise right now. Similarly, highly detailed fonts are fun, but can make it difficult for the text on the screen to be understood quickly. So you can see one of these examples is a lot easier to understand right away. Now, I don't want to tell you that you can't use fun fonts. You can easily get more creative when you have less words displayed much larger, like these examples. Also, the longer a graphic is going to be more visible, the more flourish you can add to it, up to a reasonable point. Graphics that don't contain text can follow very similar recommendations. We still want to consider what we're communicating and how to best do that. Is the graphic meant to be a focal point that is going to be large and on the screen for a short amount of time? Then it should be bold and simple. Is it meant to be unobtrusive, like a watermark? Then it should be pretty small and have low contrast so it's not constantly drawing the eye to it. Is it supposed to create an ambiance? Then it should take up a sufficient amount of the screen to properly convey that impact. Placement is another important consideration that can affect the scale of your designs. Aside from making sure that your graphic won't obstruct video, there are also parts of the video that are considered safe to put graphics and text inside. It's a standard inherited from analog video that can still affect our digital displays. Video can overscan, which means that the area outside of these edges might not make it onto your screen. If your graphics are placed in the extreme corners or edges, they may only be partially visible. You can't always control whether or not the displays you're running to will overscan. You may just be in charge of the graphics and not be allowed to change monitor settings, or a piece of equipment between the AV Bridge Matrix mix and your display might be causing the overscan. Or you might be converting one of the outputs of the AV Bridge Matrix mix to analog to connect to an existing analog distribution system. If you're confident that your system won't encounter this, then you have the whole video real estate to play with. But if you're unsure, it's probably best to design within the safe zone. The safe zone being 10% on either side and 5% on top and bottom. This doesn't mean don't put anything there, just don't put anything important in those spots. Thank you for sticking with me through that. As a reward for your patience, here's a hedgehog in a party hat. Thank you for joining me again to talk about designing more useful graphics. Stay tuned for our next video in the series, which covers the Matrix Mix's graphics library, and visit vadio.com to learn more about the AV Bridge Matrix Mix.